How you doing, Chloe?
Embrace Kim as his newly found dear friend was a pretty remarkable scene. Steven, what exactly was President Trump expecting in return for this historic gesture of stepping into North Korea and shaking hands with a dictator of that kind of brutality at this stage of the U.S. relationship with North Korea? I think the only thing he hoped and expected was that this would be the moment to get negotiations to the stalemate that started again. And the only thing he got in return was a promise that American negotiators and North Korean negotiators would meet sometime in a few weeks. But even before the president sent that tweeted invitation to Kim, my reporting had shown that inside the administration there was a growing awareness that the only way they were going to break the stalemate was to try to get the North Koreans to agree to a nuclear freeze, that is, to stop making new nuclear material, so that the problem isn't getting worse while the president is trying to negotiate his long-run objective, which is full denuclearization. I just think a freeze is simply locking in the current North Korean nuclear situation. That's right. And that may be all that Kim Jong-un wants, because when Kim Jong-un looks around the world, he sees countries where the United States previously demanded that we would never tolerate having nuclear weapons. And we've tolerated it in Pakistan. We've tolerated it with India. We don't talk about it, but we've tolerated it with Israel, right? And so the North Koreans have basically taken the position, if they could get away with it, why can't we?
Mm-hmm. And so far, there's been not that much evidence from the Trump administration that they can't get away.
That's right. The North Koreans, the president will say, have not conducted a nuclear test since the winter of 2017. And he's right about that. They have not conducted an intercontinental ballistic missile test. And that's what we were worried about, because those are the missiles that could reach L.A. or Chicago, or maybe one day New York or Washington. That doesn't mean their nuclear program will stop. In fact, they continue to manufacture American intelligence believes, and they probably can turn out about 10 bombs worth of material, roughly, every year. So the president may be recognizing that while he's got right now a stalemate, he needs to be able to go into the election season saying that he's done better than that, that he's actually gotten the North Koreans to stop making nuclear material. I know that when you get them in private, many in the administration say, we're never going to get North Korea to give up all of its nuclear weapons. But if the president can use his relationship with Kim Jong-un to at least better the atmosphere and get them to give up something, wouldn't that be an improvement?
Mm-hmm.
And the answer to that is yes, but it's far, far short of the president's promise when he came into office that he was going to solve this problem one way or the other. So what's the big lesson to this? Well, one of the big lessons is it pays to have nuclear weapons. There may be only 9 countries right now in the world that have them. But if you're Chairman Kim running a small, rogue country, nuclear weapons are...